okay. Roll up. The car, okay. Go yard the bag, okay. Filled up. Three-story pad, okay. Up. Run through some cash, okay. Four facts. I got that bad, okay. I'm on these, okay. Yeah. I'm on the flight, okay. Okay. I'm on G6, okay. G6. Forever lit, okay. Forever lit. Okay.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 19 on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got what should be a good one.
All right, coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the New York Giants and the San Francisco 49ers. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. First carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels. Because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, he breaks through. It's nothing but room to run.
Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a third and 13. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Here's Lauletta looking to hit Matthews, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Akello Witherspoon, and they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. To the INT. It's Garoppolo. They'll roll him out right. And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. A good pickup there. 26 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Southern man, this is Jerick McKinnon. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
It's Garoppolo. This is caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. 23 yards on the play. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown 13, on them. 13. Look out. You've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Jerick McKinnon, his second touchdown on the season. And the Niners have taken the early lead. Well, that turned out how they wanted. Run the toss play to the left side, go for that pylon, get in there.
And just being able to understand where the pylon was and sneak it in there, well done, well executed.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Gold now out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And the Giants ready to come out now.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
They go play action here on first down. Blitz coming and down he goes.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
Looking to throw on second down. Schmidt. That's complete to Williams out of the backfield. And down he'll go at the 25. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. What you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. Now, they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-0 lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say, when you're running the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Here's Garoppolo on first and 10. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out and ended up with an interception.
And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Vic Beasley, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
Now that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football. Led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
Play action. Now Garoppolo. And this is going to be incomplete. The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin. And now it's third down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down. Then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back. But it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
An incomplete pass on that last play. And that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Open man is Pettis. It's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football, and they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. looking to throw. Garoppolo. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A gain of 4 on the play, and it's a second down.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
From midfield, here's Garoppolo. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Garoppolo to his tight end Kittle for a Niner first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Flush to his right. Wide open receiver complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
McKinnon. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive. And here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. This will be caught just inside the 10. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Taylor Gabriel, his second touchdown on the season. And the 49ers add on to their lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. We get a look at Sterling Shepard as he and the rest of the offense march out into place. And you look at the numbers, not only has he not caught a pass, they haven't targeted him yet, and we're coming up toward halftime.
And you remember our meeting with the coach beforehand? What did he tell us about
him?
I write his number on my play sheet, and I circle it in bold, bold type because I want to make sure he gets the ball and often.
And he's brought down after a very nice game. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Detroit!
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
On second down, Cook. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Giants. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that'll make our score 14-7. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. Here's Dante Pettis on the return. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
On first down, Garoppolo. He's going to loft one deep left side. It's caught inside the 25. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. Garoppolo able to find Goodwin for a big one. 66 yards.
Tell the truth, partner. You didn't think he was coming down with that one, did you? Come on, tell me the truth.
No, I didn't. I'll tell you what, though. A one-handed grab of that length. Talk about giving your team a little juice.
Oh, big time. I mean, everyone's going to be excited about that one. Whether you're on the field or not, it permeates its way through the entire team. And I can't wait to see what they do on the next down.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Jerick McKinnon, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the 49ers add six to their lead. Gold with the extra point, and it's now 21-7. Gold now out to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one.
All right, here we go. 3-19! 3-19!
To throw on second down, Schmidt, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Looking to throw. Schmidt throwing the out route incomplete. That's Williams. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. But those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Moved back to the 10, they'll try on 2nd and goal here. Operating from the gun, Schmidt, and down he goes. The 49ers get there. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. So 3rd and goal, and the 49er faithful making some noise for their defense. From the gun, Schmidt going to throw deep for the end zone. So they took a shot there on 3rd down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground, and now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
And Zuerlein's kick is good, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know
then they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Meanwhile, out in Los Angeles, they're in the second quarter now. And the Rams have opened it up to lead by a couple of touchdowns now. Tyrod Taylor with one touchdown pass thus far. The clock showing just 16 seconds till the half as they line up first and 10. Garoppolo on first down. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. Here's second and 10 now from about the 32.
Wait.
Garoppolo again here on second and 10. Trying to lay one up deep. And that one falls incomplete. A 50-50 ball. A little dangerous. Could have been picked. Now it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Garoppolo, a final shot here before half. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we've hit halftime here in Santa Clara with the 49ers out in front. This is taken at his 4. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at about the 32. Now a play fake here on first down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And who's got it? The Giants!
With no running backs in the backfield to help pass protect, all the receivers in their patterns, these are going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case, never even had a chance. They popped the ball free in the backfield.
Following the fumble recovery, Loletta got a man over the middle. It's Williams. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, the offense can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number one against the run. But it's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against them either.
Now it's Loletta, and probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away, and that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
These guys had to settle for a field goal their last time moving the ball down the field. They may have to do it again on this drive. That could be frustrating.
Yeah, I don't want to be cliche, but at least they were able to get three last time. Three here, not the worst thing in the world. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So they recovered the fumble, but ultimately could not take advantage of the short field.
Definitely a lost opportunity right there. I mean, they were in prime position to put 6 on the board. Ended up settling for 3.
This is taken at his 4. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. Running, it's Drake across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
when we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Now a play fake. Garoppolo escaping the pressure right. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And that is incomplete.
Certainly looked like maybe his 3rd or his 4th read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. And that hits at the 6 and carries into the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash,
super toe. I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Here's Lauletta now on 2nd. Got some room at the 30. He targets Jordan Matthews, and it's gone. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside. Now the ball delivered.
And the Niners get there and bring him down.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Well, they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Cook with a 1st down and much more. The 30, 20, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, New York. A great effort there. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Giants are a 2-point conversion away from tying this football game. The Giant offense going to stay on the field as they'll go for 2.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
Out of the gun, Lauletta. And it's incomplete. But a flag is down here, so hang on. Let's see what we've got.
Illegal touching. Offense.
And they will elect to decline the penalty.
Everything turned out the way they wanted it to. No sense in even having to take that one, hence the decline.
This fielded at the 2. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Give them 9 there on the 1st down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. Ndamukong Suh makes the tackle.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Second down, here's Garoppolo. Throw left side, caught by Goodwin. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now on the afternoon. Garoppolo now, 11 of 16 through the air. It's first and 10. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's been a good one so far, just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. On first down, Drake finding room to the 20. And finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
I'm still an old school football guy, and anytime you see a big time running play, that fires me up. And if I'm on offense right now, in the position they're in now, inside the 10-yard line, I think after the way they've run it, they've set themselves up for a good play action pass opportunity right here.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. McKinnon. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Jerick McKinnon, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the 49ers add on to their lead.
With three scores in this game, I think that deserves some type of a broad gesture. I know in hockey, that's called a hat trick and people throw their hats out on the ice. What about us? What can we do for this guy?
Well, if I'm his teammates, I'm buying him a little steak dinner tonight, right? At least a skirt steak, probably a filet.
Oh, you're going big. I like that.
Yeah, I mean, skirt at minimum, skirt filet steak. At
Come
maximum.
On. You can't give the guy a skirt steak.
That's true. Filet. 10 ounce. 16 ounce.
Porterhouse.
Fine. And New York set to take the field. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Green, 39! Green, 39!
Now Lauletta on first down. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. Escape and nothing but daylight ahead. Touchdown, Giants! Evan Ingram, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Giants able to get this back within a touchdown. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call, but he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays. But it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs. Keep possession like a football.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Flushed out right. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Fielded just inside the 30. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. And here comes the Giants offense back out onto the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, to see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one...
Looking for his receiver, Sharp, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
So after the INT, it's Garoppolo throwing right, and that's complete. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack?
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. He'll find Taylor. That's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Just a five-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one. They'll run. It's Drake. He's got a first down and more inside the 30. And across the track into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. Kenyon Drake, his sixth. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. Important extra point up and through, and it might seal the deal as that makes it a two-score game here with not a lot of time remaining. Gold now out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The New York set to take the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you can play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And that one blown up quickly. as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Now Lauletta. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 42, and they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down two scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. But I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Good starting field position for the 49ers as they have it first and 10.
21.
They'll start the drive with Drake. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. And now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. As they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Oh, Garoppolo's going to throw it. Got a man open. It's Ricky Seals-Jones. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Garoppolo to throw. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. And it's second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
On second down, it's Drake. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now on first down, Drake again. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. A gain of 3, second down.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. On the give, this is Drake. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that'll bring up a third and 11 situation.
You got four. Go ahead.
Now Garoppolo. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35. Two-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy because with a two-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
Try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. That's caught inside the 20. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the next...